you work for 7 years, 5 years with literally hundreds of people, you gather data, and then you have the opportunity to have the primary publication, the one aspect that you're testing. But you're really gaining information on so many different things. Of course, the more information that's out there, the better. But it's the how and when and why. My challenge from Dr. Drazen was, let's get the people involved in the trials side to give their perspective. How do we share the data? How do we check the integrity of the data, make it available to others in a timely way, and at the same time, use the resources of those who work so hard for those 5 years to scratch the data themselves, to learn from it themselves, to train our younger investigators how best to probe data. You know, I often say the easiest paper to write is the primary. You set out what it was going to be, you had your major question. But if I look back over my career, some of the ones I'm most proud of are the things we've learned in addition to the primary by looking at the data. Now, of course, you can't be definitive. You have to put it in the proper context. But that's so much fun. And it isn't something that happens immediately. And that's what the sprint challenge is about. What will we learn if we just let the world have access to this data? And that's global. If bright minds all over the world are working on something, will we come up with something faster and which was important? But the part that I've always emphasized, and it should be something that the sprint investigators themselves would not have done. So I think the people who did the trial know their data best. They know the warts, they know the strong points. They should have a little time to scratch their data. But then, yes, the world can have it, and let's see what we learn, and let's see if we learn something important and faster. The challenge.